Prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Giving thanks, Almighty God, for your presence here, for sending your Son, Jesus Christ, to take flesh, to be born, to reveal to us the light of your love, to allow us to share in your very life. You called us to be your family, adopted us as your own. Help us to live in that spirit as your children, and as we honor Jesus Christ on this day, to grow in imitation of his virtues, of his mindset, of generosity, kindness, and a faithfulness to you, O Heavenly Father. We turn to you now as your children, adopted in your grace, and we pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
The Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Enjoy the show.
Take a drink. I can recruit woman, child, beast, or man. For delivering presents? Let's see. There's Joe Ganalkovich. He's north of Chisholm on Highway 73. He'd be perfect. He's got a big farm, so I'm sure he could dig up a sleigh. And you know those old Slovenians. They can always find their way. So give Joe a call. I'm sure he's your man. Dial 218-254-1530. Anyone can fit the bill, he can.
Old Ganalkovich picked up the phone, and what he heard was a sorrowful, monotone moan. He heard Santa tell him through the sniffles and sneezles.
Doc Elfie tells me it's probably measles. I do not feel good stuck here in my bed, as the voices of children do ram through my head, as they wake Christmas morning, a whining and wailing, and bare-bottomed birches point out Santa's failing. Mr. Ganalkovich, I do so implore you to take on this mission I set out before you. From Hibbing to Duluth to Ely or Bust, I hear Mr. Ganalkovich is the one I can trust.
But Santa, don't you realize what you're asking of me? My livestock are bedded, and we've decorated the tree. Sophie, would you please keep the kids still? It's a long distance call from Santa, who's mighty ill.
Can't you tell? Daddy's making the call. You know as well as me, the presents come from the mall.
Now, kids, your father is trying to hear. It's not nice to fight, especially this time of year.
Daddy, tell him he's wrong. He said there's no Santa Claus. Daddy, tell him he's wrong.
But Santa, I just can't do it because, yes, Virginia, there is a Santa Claus.
Ha!
Okay, Mr. Claus. If it's for the kids, it's a good enough cause. I'll see what I can do. I'll get my cows to help, and somehow we'll get through.
Off to his barn, he did plow through the snow, out across the range. His trusty Holstein must go.
Thank you.
to do. I don't know how. Santa needs our help, and he needs it right now. So pay attention. We need a good plan, but I need your ideas. Think as hard as you can. Now don't get excited. We don't need no stampede. But I just finished listening to Santa Claus plead. I know at milking time, you cows always come through. But there's something pretty wild I have to ask you to do. I know this is going to sound really strange, but we've got to deliver presents all over the range.
Now let me see if I've got this straight. It's up to us to play a reindeer so Christmas won't be late?
Well, yeah. I guess if you put it that way, you cows will be pulling my sleigh.
It's simply impossible. It cannot be done.
Oh, yes, it can, and it's going to be fun. The first thing we need to find is a good sleigh. I think there's one buried out under the hay.
We can wear bells and learn to fly, just like Santa's reindeer high in the sky.
I am not going to fly, and that is all. I do not look kindly on that kind of fall.
Sig's right, you know. We'll just walk all the way. Just think, my very own Holstein pulling a Santa sleigh.
Now let's all work together to make it easier for Joe. He's been good to us for many years, you know. Now does every cow know what they're going to do?
Uh-huh. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Where's Margaret? I thought she was with you.
The adrenaline flowed as they shook with a titter, and each bovine hair on each bovine did flitter. Gertrude and Sally dug through the hay, and quick as a wink they found the old sleigh. Those Holsteins did raise such a clatter, it drew Sophie from the house to see what was the matter.
As Joe tried to harness the cows, he soon realized that these 7 Holsteins had to be lined up according to size. Each cow was certain that she would be in the lead, quickly creating the 7 Holstein stampede.
they prepared for departure, their tails swaying and switching, as Mrs. Vinopovich yelled from the kitchen.
And a secure load, Joe's dairy best team went off down the road.
Vinopovich did holler, a red woolly scarf from his hand to each collar.
On Sigrid, on Sally, on Karma, on Gertrude.
And the more Vinopovich yelled, the more the cows.
Pay attention, and do not forget, the cow to follow tonight is Margaret.
He yelled with some gusto. 28 hooves marched row by row down Highway 73, seven sleek milkers go.
Watch out for that mailbox!
By sounds of singing from out of Joe's pass. The cows heaved a sigh as Joe stopped them at last.
Thank you.
The Iron Man chuckled and laughed to himself. As he watched the cow reindeer with the jolly farm elf. They came to North Hibbing, just moving along. Boy, were they surprised to see that all the houses were gone. They skidded to a halt at the edge of the mine.
Holy cow! We stopped just in time!
They quietly walked past the Greyhound Museum. They didn't want that skinny dog to see them. And nerves were on edge as they went past Fraboni.
Just be grateful, milk cows!
Don't make good.
They made good time, but Howard Street took them a while. Cause right down the center was a humongous snow pile. Through Highland Park, Cobb Cook, and Greenhaven, too.
Okay, it's 169, then down 73. It's stormy than Bloodfoot, but I'm sure we'll get through.
Look at all these farms! Betsy, I feel right at home! Let's go for some hay! I can hear my second stomach growing!
All right, Bob, I'm going to deliver these gifts. You can go out to the farm and give this place a smash.
Look at this! Boingers,
on Margaret's route was that high-toned big city known as Duluth. Arriving on top of a hill by the Miller Hill Mall, they looked out over the lake, afraid they might fall. As our Holstein heroes stood gazing down at the lights, a gale blew off the lake, but Ganapovich held tight.
The wind it blew hard as it waffled and wrangled, till the seven Holstein cows and seven scarves became tangled. They bounced down they twisted and turned, but it was no avail. They bounced down Central Entrance on their tails. Slipping and sliding up hills and down, they emptied 13 sacks.
Thing. The
Margaret's route was that high-toned big city known as Duluth. Arriving on top of a hill by the Miller Hill Mall, they looked out over the lake, afraid they might fall. As our Holstein heroes stood gazing down at the lights, a gale blew off the lake, but Ganapovich held tight.
The wind it blew hard as it waffled and wrinkled, till the seven Holstein cows and seven scarves became tangled. They bounced down some, they twisted and turned, but it was no avail. They bounced down Central Entrance on their tails. Slipping and sliding, uphills and down, they emptied 13 sacks.
Big boom. Feels like the walls are coming down.
twisting and turning down that corkscrew lane, Margaret, the lead cow, stopped the team like a derailed train. Just as their fears had predicted about the wild, they met a great beast that just stood there and would not smile.
As the stranger with gifts turned to go, Margaret informed them.
That was a moose, just so you know.
All around Ely, they delivered gifts so quick that if you didn't know it, you'd think it was Saint Nick. Going out of Ely, they stopped by Shagwa Lake.
Thanks to the Gitche Manitou, which means the creator.
moving south from Lake Vermilion on the journey's last leg, each muscle in each Holstein for a rest did beg. Hard to believe, as they approached the hill, it was three skiers.
It's 4 a.m. Guess they can't get their fill.
As the three snow-covered people toward them did speed, it was obvious that
a ski for each leg is what we need.
Cowabunga, dude! It's a troop of heifers and a farmer guy. I bet these cows could get some air if they tried.
Looks like you're on a mission of peace and goodwill. Could you help us by taking some presents up the hill?
When the lift starts running at 8 a.m., we'll haul those gifts up as fast as we can.
We can help you for sure. Carrying stuff up and down these slopes.
By the time they reached Virginia, they knew it was getting late. They finished Mountain Iron with an hour till sunrise on Christmas Day. Buell was the only place left to give presents away. Though Joe warned them not to climb the tower, for the world's finest water, they somehow found the power.
They slipped off the tower with an oof plop and landed abruptly in the snow on a rooftop. The force of their landing did cause such a clatter that it woke up the kids and the mom and the dadder.
Thank you.
And then Mr. Ganapovich, his last chimney descended, turned his cows homeward. Their mission had ended. He arrived at the farm with the snow gently blowing. As Joe unharnessed the team, each cow's pride was showing.
Well, thank you, cows. It's been a job well done. Now I'm going to bed before we see the sun.
This has been a night to remember. Just like that first Christmas night in December.
Wouldn't it be neat to have been a cow in the stable when Mary and Joseph used a manger for a cradle?
So Joseph set out from the town of Nazareth in Galilee and traveled up to Judea to the town of David called Bethlehem, since he was of David's house and line, in order to be registered together with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. While they were there, the time came for her to have her child. She gave birth to a son, her firstborn. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. That same night, in the fields near Bethlehem, some shepherds were taking care of their sheep. When a bright light shined down on them, they were scared.
joy is to be shared by the whole people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. And here is a sign for you. You'll find the baby wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger.
So they hurried away and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger. Wise men from the east followed one very bright star. It led them to where Jesus was with his mother Mary. The wise men bowed down and honored Jesus. They gave him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Thus it was that our Lord Jesus was born in the humble stable in the town of Bethlehem.
Thank you.
They realized as their hearts filled with dread that they'd given as gifts all the stuff from the shed. And in the house, Joe was awakened by a four-alarm rumbling as his hand toward the nightstand was frantically fumbling. He clung to his phone and he clung to his bed and he shook off his sleep as he shook his thick head. And he listened intently to what Santa said.
I'm feeling much better. My fever has dropped. But we were all wondering why you never stopped to pick up the packages, the gifts, and the trappings that my elves wrapped in their fine, colorful wrappings.
The truth hit Ganapovich like a shovel in the head. His knees turned to jello and his face turned beet red.
The gifts we delivered were things from the shed! Oh.
Hey, Mom, this is neat. Santa brought me a bag full of wheat.
Great tape. Guess what? Now I can tape my math book shut.
Wow! I got a ring! I can grow two peas, and my mom can make the cake!
Joe, you're a success, don't you know? It's not the gifts that you give. It's the love that you show.
It's not the gifts that you give. It's the love that you show.
Then Ganapovich rested happily after his long stormy hike, because he knew in his heart that the world was all right.
Yeah.
jobs, Will. I'm Dave Pritchett. I'm the principal of Assumption Catholic School. And one of the jobs that I was given by Ms. Kay is to thank all of you for coming here, for braving the snow, the huge snow piles, and helping to be part of this experience. All right. I would also like to thank everybody for the immense amount of work that went into this production. Whether your name is in the program or not, thank you, thank you, thank you very much. I would also like to thank our general and our field marshal over here, Ms. Kay and Ms. Ronchetti, for commanding the group. Figuring out the coordinates and carrying out the mission. Thank you so, so much. And a huge thank you, danke sehr, grazie, spasiba, to these students whose hard work and dedication made this such a memorable experience. Let's give them a round of applause. Moment and thank Jesus. The reason that we're all here, it's his birthday that we're celebrating, and please remember the true meaning of Christmas. So one job done, I don't think I screwed up anything. Don't worry, Miss Kay, I'm on it. Alright, so the other task that I was given was talk a little bit about the message of the show. Sometimes in the immense amount of cuteness we can miss that, right? Farmer Joe was given a task that he didn't want and didn't feel qualified for us. But because of his love, he was able to complete it. I'm being snuck up upon here, all right. So, we all have burdens, we all have tasks, we all have things that life puts upon us. But just please remember, like Farmer Joe, God never places a burden on us without giving us the strength to complete it. All right, so, one thing that I do need to remind you, there won't be refreshments at St. Leo's Hall. And one other thing, this might sound strange, but this production is not that extraordinary. And the reason I say that is because every once in a while, Father Dan will say, Dave, where do you see God moving in your life? And my answer is, every day, in the immense love that this staff has for your children, and the immense love that these children have for everybody around them. It's truly a blessing to step into this building every day and see God moving through the actions of everybody around me. Assumption School is a very, very special place, and we are all blessed to be here.
Merry Christmas to all. Are you ready?
Merry Christmas to all, and to all a good night.
Everybody likes to take a rest.
The pre-K has a special goodbye song. The sixth graders, we invite the sixth graders to come and take your bows.